Hello and welcome, my friends. Once again, welcome in this new video. So, in this Corona episode, we are medical or non-medical persons. We much avoid some medical terminology, like that the first word we all much avoid nowadays. The word is that the pandemic. Pan does means that the whole. Whole does means that stands for pan. Now, pan is again add with epidemic. Now here is the word is that the epidemic. Epidemic is, does means that the once a disease is suddenly spread in a big community, in a big state, in a big country, is called the episode is called that the epidemic. Now the next word is the endemic. Endemic is the like that the situation when a disease is continuously persists. In a particular state or in a particular district or in a particular very small city, and continuously many people are not affected, but to some extent some people are continuously affected someday with some particular disease like that malaria or dengue, in such the communicable diseases, is called that the endemic condition. So the epidemic, the pandemic is the epidemic of the throughout the world. Epidemic is the sudden outburst of the of a disease in a state or in a country, and endemic is the that condition when continuous persistence in a small population or a small city or a small group of people. Now the endemic. Endemic is that the endemic is can cause the pandemic. Now what is the mean that the endemic? Endemic is that word that is spread through a traveler, like the corona. Corona is nowadays spread due to travelers by their unknowingly obviously, but the endemic is that the, that is that the disease is spread with the through the mode of the travelers from one country to another country, which can lead to the condition pandemic. So endemic is that word, endemic another word, epidemic, and now the pandemic. Now there is the another word, that is the exotic. Exotic does means the unnatural occurring of a disease in a unnatural population, like that the malaria or leishmaniasis, that is the kalajar. Malaria or kalajar is generally happening in the tropical areas. But if suddenly a Britain, in the Britain or in the America, suddenly if it is found to some people in the cold region, so this condition is known as the exotic condition. Now the ek or, now start with the ek or ek, that is the means that the out of, that is the eccentric. The first word is the eccentric. That is the apart from the center. So if you assume a cell like that, round is that the cell, and here is the center, which is nearest to the center is the centric, and which is apart than the other organelles like ribosomes or mesosome. If the other organelles are lying apart from the center, is called that the condition eccentric. And if the condition is like that, that it is tend to go to the center, like in a manner of the jalebi. So this condition is known as the concentric. So this is concentric and this is eccentric. Now the next word is the ek, that is having or holding, that is the echinocyte. Echinocyte is something that the bar cell, B-U-R-R, bar cell, that is a special type of RBC, that is the crenated or spiky RBCs. This is due to the loss of the inner fluid. So crenated RBC is known as the bar cell or the echinocyte. Now the next word is the ect, that is the outside, that is the ectoplasm, that is the in between the, here is the cytoplasm, something is that the here is the if this is the cytoplasm, this blue part is only the cytoplasm throughout the cell, the cytoplasm throughout the cell, and the thin layer is living between the cell membrane and the cytoplasm, a thin but sticky layer in between the cytoplasm and the cell membrane is called the ectoplasm. Now the ect or ecto, that means the outer or external, that is happening, that is apart from where it could be. Like that the ectopic. Ectopic is that word like that the we much use with the ectopic pregnancy, because the pregnancy is happening in the part of uterus. If it is the fetus is resides in the fallopian tube, then it is called as the ectopic pregnancy. Now again, the what is the ectomy? Ectomy does means that the surgical removal, that is the appendectomy. That is the removal of the appendix, which is may be inflamed or not. If it is inflamed, it is appendicitis, or if it is not inflamed, it is appendix only. So removal of the appendix in any condition, inflamed or in non-inflamed, that is known as the appendectomy. Now the ectro, ectro means that the congenital absence, the absence of the since by birth. That is the ectodactyl. Ectodactyl, dactyl does stands for the phalanges, the fingers of the, my hands or the foot. So the these phalanges is commonly known as the dactyl or digits. That is the ectodactyl is that the absence of some fingers since birth. So this is known as the ectodactyl. Now the ED does means the well, that is the well, that edentulous. Edentulous is that the lacking of teeth. It may be a lacking of one particular or two number of teeth, or the whole number of teeth in the old ages. This is known as the edentulous. Edema is also not like the same term. Edema is that something is inflamed is called the edema. So something that is edema may be written as like that. Edema, but it is always pronounced as the edema. Edema is that something that the inflamed thing, maybe inflamed body parts, is called the edema. The elect or does stands for the electron, because our body is totally mechanized with the electrical charges, and through the electrical devices we can try to understand the function of the heart. That is that is known as the electrocardiograph. If some electrical device we about to learn about the how the brain is functioning, or the whether brain is functioning properly or not properly, that test is known as the electroencephalography. The electrolyte commonly it means that fluid which contains ions. The when we dissolve sodium chloride, the sodium and chloride ion get in the ionic form in that water. But the electrolyte in the medical term is the ionic concentration, does only means the electrolyte is the ionic concentration of the many like the main the sodiums, chloride, carbonates, potassium, bicarbonates. So these are the ionic concentration is commonly called as the electrolytes. Now the aim is that the embolism, small air bubble or the fat globules that can inhibit my blood circulation process. That is the call is the embolism. The embedding is that means that the bedding of something very small thing to a great mass. So this is a histopathological process a small tissue is embedded in a big mass of wax. So that is known as the embedding. The emesis is the disease condition that is known as the emesis, does means that vomiting. The in does means that the inside, or the like what is that encapsulated. Some bacteria also resides inside a capsule, like the medicines. Some bacteria naturally they have a capsule. These bacteria are commonly called as encapsulated bacteria. Now the end or endo, that means that the within or inner, the endemic we discussed previously. The endoderm, the derm stands for the skin, and the end with the skin we all of we know that the we our skin has three layers. The upper layer is the epidermis, the mesoderm, and the innermost layer is the endoderm. So the endometrium is the special type of tissue that only inside the resides only inside the uterus. So some females also with some complaints of endometriosis. Endometriosis is that disease condition when this endometrium tissues resides also outside the outer layer of the uterus. That condition is known as the endometriosis. The endothelium is the innermost layer of the blood vessels or the heart. The innermost layer is known as the endothelium. The endotoxin, here is the another term, somewhere is the, it is that the exotoxin. When a bacteria causes pathogenicity in my body, this is causes disease. But, so disease is that the bacteria release some toxins in my body. Inside my body, the bacteria release some toxins. When the bacteria release that toxins, that toxins is known as exotoxin. But when my antibodies or the whatever the medicines I have that, so due to that, when the bacterial cell is ruptured, from the inside of the bacterial cell, some toxin is also come out. This toxin is known as the endotoxin. Now the entero does means that about the intestine, that the enteralgia, the algia does stands for the pain. So enteralgia, the paining in the intestine, that is the upper abdominal part especially. So the enterectomy, when a doctor removed some part of the intestine due to some disease, that process is known as the enterectomy. The enteric, that is the enteric disease. The enteric disease are the group of disease which if I suffering from diarrhea. So diarrhea is that disease in the group of the enteric disease that is happened due to my mouth. With my mouth, if I have some water or some liquid or some food, that due to some that food or contaminated food or contaminated water, that disease, if I have, these diseases are the group of the enteric diseases. Like that, the enteric fever, the typhoid is an enteric fever. Because the portal of entry of the typhoid disease, that is the Salmonella bacteria, causative organism, the causative organism of typhoid is Salmonella. And Salmonella only enters through our mouth, that is the portal of entry. So the typhoid disease is only happened when it is ported through my mouth, is the enteric fever. Like that, the malaria. Malaria is not a enteric fever or enteric disease. Malaria only happens through the blood contamination. If through the mosquito bites or the blood transfusion I have that, so through that entry, through the blood contamination, malaria, so the portal of entry of malaria is that the blood, the contact of blood. But the typhoid is happening only when it is ported through the mouth. Now the AP does stands for the above, upon, or in addition, that is the epidermis. Epidermis, that is the upper skin layer of the skin. So the epididymis is a long channel, about 7 meter long channel, that is through the spermatozoa is traveled, and during that 7 meter traveling, the spermatozoa became adult, became a complete spermatozoa that can fertilize. So epididymis is that the channel that is from the bears the spermatozoa from the testis to the vasa deferens. Now the epiglottis. Epiglottis is the small leaf-like structure that is positioned at the just above the root of the tongue. Just above the root of the tongue, the small leaf-like structure is known as epiglottis. Now with some epi words, there is some diseases. That the epidemic, that is the sudden outburst of a disease in a big community, is that the epidemic. The epilepsy is that the sudden seizure. sudden seizure of a, some patients are suffering from sudden seizures is that known as epilepsy. Or the epistaxis. Epistaxis is that the bleeding through nose, bleeding throughout the nose is known as epistaxis. Now arg, that is arg, arg is a unit of work or energy, that is one arg is equal to 10 to the power 7 joule. So arg also means that the work or activity, the ergonomics. Ergonomics is itself a big science which deals with the specially designing of the of our daily utilization, our chair, tables, beds, everything, the, which deals with the big science, which deals with the our everyday requirement to design, to comfort, to be all these things are friendly, our most ergonomic. The arto, arot or aroto, arto, that is the sexual desire or love, that is the erotomania. Erotomania is that a disease when a patient is suffering from the delusion. So the, that patient is known as the erotomaniac. The erythro or erythro is means that the redness, that is the erythema. Erythema, when some people are suffering, the when their capillaries are burst inside the ruptures inside the body, the redness is occurring above the skin. This redness is known as the erythema. The erythrocytes stands for red blood cells. Or now the SO means inside, that is the esophagus, that is commonly known as the food pipe, that is from our throat to the stomach is known as the esophagus. Now the ST does means the perceiveness or feelingness. That N does, when it is the N is added before it, it becomes negative, because anesthesia is such a procedure by that the surgeons usually do that, so the anesthesia procedure is done before the operation. So U is a very fine word. U is a prefix that means that the good or well or easy or normal. U, that the U bacteria is a complete or typical bacteria, is known as the U bacteria, that have a rigid cell wall, that have a flagellum for movement. So this type of bacterial cell is known as the U bacteria. The euphoria, you may heard about the euphoria band, that is of the Dr. Paula cell. The euphoria is does means that the well-beingness, cheerfulness. So cheerfulness is the basic theme of your life. If you do not cheerful by yourself, nobody can give you the cheerfulness or well-beingness to you. Nobody can gift you that. So you always you try to cheerful, always you try to well-being. That is the main philosophy of the life. The euthyroid. Euthyroid is that condition, that is the normal thyroid condition. That is the U that stands for the normal thyroid. When the thyroid gland is functioning properly, is called commonly called euthyroid. Now the X or XO does means that the out or outer, that is the excision. Excision is that the procedure when a small piece of tissue is extracted from my body for the testing purposes is known as the excision. The excretion is the process of eliminating waste from my body. The exogenous, genus means the generation, generate. So the causing of the disease, the, if it is exogenous or endogenous. So when I am affected from suffering from fever and coughing, that is doctor telling me that you are suffering from corona. So if I have that corona, so corona is the exogenous cause, that is not the inclusion of my body part. Corona is attack to my body and I got that attack of COVID virus. So this is called the exogenous. So exogenous, that is the cause of, that is the external cause. The exophthalmic, sometimes the ophthalmic does means that the eye, when the eye comes out, when the looking that the somebody's eyes are comes out, this is a condition happening in the goiter condition, it is known as the exophthalmic. So exotoxin is the unnatural happening of a disease in a unnatural town or community, the endotoxin, exotoxin that is released by the bacteria. Now the extra that is outside or beyond, that is the extracellular, so that is comes from the outside of the cell. The extraction, when a major such as the, if a tumor is extracted from a body, that is known as the extraction. When a huge mass or a large number of tissue is detached from my body, is known as the extraction. The exudate is the tissue fluid that is rich in protein and found in the disease condition, is known as the exudates. So my friends, again we meet with the few new words, new prefixes and new suffixes. So till then, goodbye.